I'd like to tell you, today we have a very important topic, which is mainly about the sanctuary. As you can see here, we try to do it here just to let every one of you can see everything and understand everything. When we are talking about the sanctuary, we can see according to the our church, it represents the main heaven itself, or God residence, the place, the residence of God, or the heaven itself. Because in this place, we can see every day in the Mass, the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ here. When we are thinking about the sanctuary, we have to remember very important things. Number one, no layman can enter to the altar, or to the sanctuary, I mean. Only the deacons or the priests, people that have to do service in the sanctuary, they are only the people that are allowed to enter to the sanctuary. The second important thing, that we can only step into the sanctuary after we take off our shoes. When we are thinking about this, we'll find that this reminds us when Moses met with the Lord and he started to talk to him. And Moses saw a very nice vision, which was the tree full of fire, and nothing happened to the tree. And when he looked at this vision, he was thinking to go and see, but the Lord told him, take off your shoes. The land or the place that you are standing on is a holy place and the holy ground. So taking off the shoes indicates the feeling of being unworthy to enter to this place, and in the same time to give us the feeling that this place is holy and we are unworthy to enter to this place. I saw a very nice thing in Ethiopia. They consider the whole church is like the heaven, not only the sanctuary. So they take off their shoes when they enter to the door, main entrance of the church. So as they consider the whole church is like heaven. So they take off their shoes before they enter to the church. Inside the sanctuary, what is the main thing which is inside the sanctuary?
The altar.
Very good, the altar. What is the meaning of the word altar? It means the place or the sculpture upon which the sacrifice are slain. But in the same time, it means the mensa, which is referred to the same thing. In the same time, it is more especially applied to the slab which the sacrifice, or which is the mainly the body and the blood put on. When we are thinking about the Coptic altar, it will find the Coptic altar take the shape of a cube, which resemble the tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in the same time, it is reminding us by the Holy Trinity, which is the three in one, and in the same time, when we are thinking about the altar of the Coptic Church, you will find that it is inside the sanctuary, according to what mentioned in the Book of Revelation. It is usually made of what you let, the altar. What kind of material we use to make the altar? Yes. Wood. Wood? Why wood?
Because wood represents the same.
Can you see what you... What do you mean?
Wood is...
Yes, wood, because it reminds us by the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, and we can see on this altar that on the altar the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, and it reminds us by the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was made of wood, and on this cross you will find that the body and the blood of the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, or where our Lord Jesus Christ was crucified. Some other altars can be made of stone, marble, or brick, and as I said, wood, and it must be hollow, so it is not a solid, no. It is just the walls, it is hollow under the altar, as I said, because the relics of the saints were there. And in the same time, the icons of the saints can be put there. So the most important thing that we can see, that the altar is either wood, stone, marble, but at the end it is a cube, it is like a cube. In the same time, it is hollow because we put there the relics of the saints. When you look above the altar in the church, up there, you will find that the altar in the same level of the church, No. What is the level of, where would the altar in comparison with the church? How many steps? Will make it easier for you.
Three steps.
Very good, three steps. So when we are thinking about the three steps that you can use it till you reach to the altar, remind us with
deacon, priest, and bishop.
Very good. I'm proud of you. The priesthood. So it reminds us with the priesthood, and it reminds us with the deacons, priests, and in the same time the bishop. The altar consecrated by who? Altar consecrated by who? By Moses? I give Moses the altar. What do you really own?
Bob
or?
Bishop.
Altar is consecrated by the bishop or the Bob. And with what you learned? Consecrated with what? Very good. With myron, oil, and this is the same thing like the same thing is applicable to anything is consecrated in the church. The bishop or the pope is the only one had the right to consecrate. To consecrate anything related to the altar or the altar itself, or the anything in the church, we usually put a covering on the altars. What is the meaning of the covering of the altars? Why we are covering the altar?
حد قال لك حاجة أنا كنت معاك. قول.
Because this is holy. ما انتي هولي انتي كمان نحط عليك كفر. Yes.
Because when Jesus was in the tomb, they covered it with a stone. Because when Jesus was in the tomb, they covered the tomb with a stone.
Because when they covered Jesus with the cloth when he was in the tomb?
Yes, but I think this comes from somewhere else. Yeah, not from yourself. Because our Lord Jesus Christ, his body was wrapped with linen when he was crucified. Clothes of the altar, usually white linen, which is mainly, as I said to you, remind us with the clothes who were wrapped by our Lord Jesus Christ. We have three coverings. We have three coverings on the altar, one after the other, which is remind us by the Holy Trinity. And at the same time, it remind us by the wrapping of our Lord Jesus Christ after he was crucified. Nothing is placed on the altar unless the holy oil element, which is used in the service of the Mass itself. I cannot bring any of the deacon's clothes and put on the altar. I cannot bring the bag of Abuna and put it on the altar. I cannot, nothing on the altar. The only thing that is allowed to be in the altar is mainly the things that are used in the service of the altar. You know these candles? Where, Peter, we have to put these candles?
On the sides, one on the left, one on the right.
Here on top of the altar? Oh,
it should be on the floor.
So Peter said, no, Yabuna, this is not right in this place. It must be on the side of the altar. It must be one from the right and one from the left. Because, as I said to you, nothing to be on the altar. The main elements that we use on the altar. In case the altar is not consecrated, what do we have to do? Huh? Huh?
We have to get an altar board and put it on the altar.
Come here. Can you say it again?
We have to get an altar board and put it on top of the altar.
Anyone of you understand anything? What he said, your last? Huh?
You have to get an altar board and put it on the altar.
Very good. Who else? Huh? Yes?
You have to get an altar board and put it on the altar.
Very good, huh? Can we say it together?
Yes.
If the altar is not consecrated, we have to get altar board. We have to get what?
An altar board.
Can you say it again?
An altar board.
What is the altar board? This is a kind of as if we have a consecrated board that we can, this is a consecrated by the bishop, and when we put this on the altar, it is considered by the church as if the altar is consecrated. This is consecrated, and when we put this on the altar, it is considered that the altar is consecrated. We can see here the sign of the cross. We can see here the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. In the same time, we can see some words in Coptic, which is mean Jesus Christ our Lord. At the same time, you can put some things which is related to the verses from the Psalm, anything. But this is what is called, what is this?
Altar.
I can't hear you. What is this?
Altar.
Why are you not saying you're into this? What is this? What is this? What is this? What is this? Can you say it together? What is this? I can't hear you. What is this?
Altar board.
And I think you didn't say it. What is this, Yolan?
Altar board.
What is this? I can't hear you.
Huh?
Can you say it again?
Altar board.
When we are using the altar board,
when the altar is not consecrated
by a bishop.
When we are using the altar board, raise your hand, please. Yes?
When the altar is not consecrated.
And this is consecrated or not? Huh? Yeah, yes. She said this is consecrated and it is used by putting this in the altar when the altar is not consecrated. And as I said to you, the cross here, Alpha and Omega, and any other words from the verses of the of the Psalms. What is the name of this part which is on the altar? This is the throne. What is the meaning of the throne? Huh? Why we are using this throne to put what we are putting here? What we are putting here?
The cup.
Cup altar, yani. Yes. Chalice, which carrying the blood of the altar. So this is the throne, and in this throne we are putting the chalice, اللي هو mainly used for putting the wine, which is later on will be the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. What is this, Yavlin? Candle what? Candle holder. When we are talking about this, how many we have here?
Two.
What is this remind? What is the meaning of those two? Those are reminding us by the two angels in the tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is why they are stayed till the end of the service, and at the end of the service, Abuna by himself put them off. As if he called the angels to leave now because the service is finished. What is this? And what is this?
The cross.
This is a cross that used in the service in the altar. But on the other hand, what is this? The gospel. What is the meaning of the gospel? Who can tell me about this? There is anything inside which is just hollow? Empty. Very good. Is it empty or not? Yes or no? No? What? Very good. Give him a big hand, Yavlin. He said no. In this we have the gospel here, and so it is not empty. It is carrying the gospel here, and We are kissing this because it's carrying the word of God. And it is used in the service when you are using this in the service.
When you're reading the gospel?
Yes, in the prayers before reading the gospel. And what else? When the deacons and the abuna do the rotation around the altar, in the readings of the epistles and in the reading of the book of Acts, they remind us by the spread of the word of God everywhere. When abuna and the deacons go around, it reminds us by the spread of the word of God around the world. And in the same time, it is considered the word of God that we remind us by the we are carrying it. Why abuna carrying this like this during the reading of the gospel in the church? Abuna take this from the deacon and put it like this. Why abuna or the bishop or the Pope himself take this and put it like this? I have a special prize for anyone who will tell me.
Just grab everyone's attention that they're reading the gospel and everyone else to stand.
Why? What is the meaning of grabbing the attention of everyone? There is no need in home. I put it like this, I shouldn't get the attention. What is the meaning of that? Yes? I can see here some. You want to say something? Yes?
Because you're like kind of bowing to the word of God. Because you're kind of bowing to the word of God.
Kind of bowing in the front of the word of God. Yes.
Because the word of God is above all people.
I love it. Yawlad, as he said, now the word of God is above all everybody. So the Pope or the bishop, the priest, is telling God that I am willing to follow your commandment. And I consider your commandment is above me and above everyone in the church. And all of us will follow the commandment or the commandment of the in the gospel. What is this, your list? The box of incense, which is we are putting on the chair on the altar, so Abuna can use it during the prayer of the and the mass. I'd like to talk with you about the sacred vessels. I bring it to you here. It is not consecrated yet, so I can show it to every one of you a very simple way. When we said the sacred vessels, it means the consecrated, and you can see in the book of Exodus that everything was used in the altar, it must be consecrated so it can be used for serving God in the altar. You shall consecrate them that they may be most holy. Whatever touches them will become holy. So those things must be consecrated. And as the Bible said, it must be consecrated, we consecrate them that they may be most holy. Whatever touches them, only touches them, must become holy. And the church in the New Testament, as Christ offers a special offering, which is the holy bread and the wine. We consider this as the same vessel that we can use in doing this service. And as I'm telling you, this must be consecrated, so it must be holy. What is this?
Chalice.
Where the chalice is the communion cup in which we mix the wine and the water, and in the same time it is consecrated before we use, and in the same time it is consecrated, it is consecrate the wine and the water during the prayer of the Mass. In the same time, the Lord Himself used this chalice, as it was written in Matthew 26:26, and the apostles imitated him, and St. Paul, the apostle, calls it the cup of blessing. It is called by St. Paul the cup of blessing, and in the same time the cup of the war of the Lord. So St. Paul, we are saying this is a chalice, but St. Paul said it is the cup of a...
Blessing.
And the cup of?
Blessing.
Cup of?
Blessing.
Another name, cup of?
Blessing.
The second name is cup of the Lord. So the first name is the cup of the blessings. The second name is cup of the Lord. And as we said in the beginning, it is used by for putting the wine and the water, and in the same time it must be consecrated by the bishop with the myron oil, so we can use it in the same time. As you can see, it is long, so it can help in using it during giving the blood for the people. In early church, it was used from wood or glass, but later on they start to use it in the 4th century from silver or gold. What is the name of this part?
The pattern.
Huh?
Pattern.
So it is called pattern. Can you say it again with me?
Pattern.
What is the use of the pattern? Huh? It is a kind of small rounded tray, and in this small rounded tray, there is no stand and having no engraving in this. It is usually used for putting the bread or the holy bread here. And so it is called the baton, which is symbolic meaning, represents the Lord's manger and tomb. So it represents two things, the Lord manger and the Lord tomb. This is why we have to put this on top of this. What is this means? What is the, it is called the dome or the star. So if we consider this as the manger, we can consider this as the
star.
If we would like to consider this the tomb, we will consider this as the stone, and this is the stem. So this is the stone, and this is the stem on the altar, on the tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ. Or if we consider the manger, we can consider this as the star. If it is the baton, and he put the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is resembling, it is looks like, we can consider that this is a symbolic thing for what you learned?
The manger or the
manger? Or
the tomb.
Boom. This why this is what is this?
The star.
So the stars all the stamp on the tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ. What is this, you learned?
Spoon.
What is the use of the spoon? It is called in Coptic mastir, and through this we administer the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, the first one is? First one is?
Chalice.
And the chalice there?
Spoon.
The second part is?
Pattern.
And what is this?
Star dome.
Star dome. And this reminds us with? Okay. What is this you learned?
The people in the hospital.
It is called? Symposium. It's called symposium. And this is used by Abuna to have the blood and the body and the blood to any person who are sick in the hospital or at home and they cannot come to the church. And this is very important thing that we can give the sick people the divine letter, the divine body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. There is a very important thing which is here. What is this you left?
Sorial.
What is in English?
Censor.
Okay. What did the Sorial remind us with? Huh? How many chains here?
Four.
This is 3 into 1. So this reminds us by the Holy Trinity and one which is the one God. So the Holy Trinity and one God. In the same time, we are putting here, what we are putting here?
Charcoal.
And the charcoal is?
Jesus.
The charcoal is your lady.
It's
burning. So it reminds us with? Sure, you remind us with what?
Saint
Mary's womb, which she carried the our Lord Jesus Christ when he was incarnated and became man. And in the same time, it reminds us by the crucifixion of our Lord Jesus Christ when we are putting the incense here and the incense start to spread and give a nice smell, which reminding us by the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was accepted in front of God the Father and giving a nice smell in front of everyone. So this is a symbolic thing for Saint Mary. In the same time, this is a Trinity into one. In the same time, it carries the charcoal and the incense. And this is reminded us by the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the same time, when we're putting the incense, it starts to give a smell, which reminds us by the acceptance of the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ in front of God the Father. I feel that we are sorry, we are kind of being late a little bit, but thank you for this special thank you. I'm sure that you have many questions, but we'll keep it for another time, and we will tell you anything you didn't understand today. Let's stand to pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, from God, amen. Let us go and say all thanksgiving, our Father who art in heaven. Thank you.